Hey folks, and welcome to game 13, lucky 13, in our series AlphaGo versus the world. Mike, Chris Garlock here with Michael Redmond. Michael, who's our human player today?
Okay, Liu Yuhang. As far as I can pronounce his name,
sounds
we have a
to
young
me.
Player again. He's born in 2001, so he's about 16 years old now. And I mean, at the time of this game, almost 16, maybe even 15, I guess.
Wow.
And he was promoted to sixth dan in 2019. So he promoted fairly quickly after that. And he had a fairly, he liked to improvise. So it wasn't as if he had a really set style. He liked to try out new moves. And actually, he's one of the players who changed very quickly with the use of AI. To study Go. So he was a player who was ready to pick up on new things. And you can see him sort of experimenting a little bit with this game also.
Oh, cool. Let's take a look at it.
So the human player has the black stones. And we are going to see again. We've seen this in a previous game, but AlphaGo is playing a Kakari when black has played a Kakari against white's lower left corner. So this is a point where before that, people would have a tendency to either answer here or maybe to play some kind of a pincer. These were the moves that were very popular. But AlphaGo just plays this Kakari against the approach move against Black's 3-4 point. And basically, AlphaGo is saying that next pressing here is going to be a big move. Mm-hmm. And this is what the AI programs like to say also. So the top human players have sort of figured that out, and nowadays you would see black continue with a move like this just to stop white from pressing at that point. So this is how the game has changed. You've probably heard me say this before, but it's a very important point. People have come back to this kosumi that was played hundreds of years ago, and there was a period when we didn't play, but it's back in fad. It's back. People are starting to play it again. At the time, people thought the double Kakari here was really big, but white just presses against the corner. So actually, in a previous game, I think we saw black crawling here, and something like this happened, which is completely reasonable. But here, black is the human player is going to try something different. So black pushes through here and cuts. Actually, kicking here... that we did not really know about at the time. We did not play this move very much at the time. But this is also a feasible move. Like if white answers like this, then black could crawl anyway. Basically, this kicking here is making mi-ai of this point. And this in this case, black can crawl or black can play the slide on the second. Playing the slide is also an idea. Or if white covers on this side, black has a nice hane here to play. So it's making mi-ai of those two points. And the idea is that if white answers this way, then that exchange was better played for black because it's not going to be forcing later on. So that's another move that has become popular now. It's another move that black could have played in this board position. But in the game, black pushes through and cuts, starting a fight here. So black is challenging white to a fight, probably with the idea that he's going to figure out whether this player can actually fight or not, because AlphaGo so far has been winning without even fighting very much.
Yeah.
So he's challenging white to a fight. Probably not the best move, but, you know, he's trying something here. Hey. So with this, black's group in the corner is perfectly okay. Because black does have a cut here. Black can cut here and capture that white stone on the left side. So for the time being, the corner group is fine, and black has time to play this move. And AlphaGo doesn't mind that. Like the fact that black has surrounded this white group and that to live, the diagram that we show to beginners or weaker players when we're teaching Go is we say that it's just so painful for white to play here. That means that it's not good to allow black to surround you like this. It's one of the variations that we talk about, but it just doesn't bother AlphaGo at all. And actually, AlphaGo is ready to sacrifice that white stone. because AlphaGo plays here, finishing white's position in the upper left. And basically the point here is the fact that black is pushed through and cut to create this group in the center of the board. If these two stones are functioning somehow to maybe attack white or to build some strength in the center of the board, if they're working in a positive fashion, then it's going to be okay for black. But if white can make those two stones wasted, if they can become useless for black, then the game is going to be good for white, regardless of whatever happens in this corner. So that's a positional judgment that we probably didn't have at the time. The fact that that fight that black has started on, the fact that black pushed through and cut here and started a fight there, makes that the hot spot. That upper left area was much more important. So white just continues with that. When white plays this extension on the third line, black does have to live in the corner now.
Right.
So black adds a stone to the corner. And white, so this is the move that was probably not expected, because white has added one more move to a position where white already had positions on both sides. And so that's just demonstrating the same point, that provided white can nullify the effect of those two black stones in this area, and white can take the attacking side, can attack black, that is more important than anything happening elsewhere on the board. So it's more important than what black is doing in the lower right corner. Black actually killed the lower left corner. The lower left corner, black has captured it, but that's not as important as the advantage that white got in the upper left. And to put it in a very simple fashion, it's the two wasted stones here, which are going to be captured in comparison to the one wasted stone here, which in fact, white is going to be able to make use of that white stone with attachments like this, or the extension here, looking at covering on the third line in the corner, stuff like that. White does have ways to make use of that dead stone there, whereas black two stones are pretty much useless. So at this point in the game, it's already very one-sided, probably close to, it's over 60% for white at this point.
It's so funny, Michael, because after, again, playing, between playing with the AI and just working with you, I can almost guess. I mean, it just feels, I mean, you sort of have a feel for it. I'm like, yeah, that's probably 55-60%, you know, and for AlphaGo, that's a walk in the park, right?
It's really important for AlphaGo. Like for myself, 60% would just be an advantage. And I'd be happy about the game, but I wouldn't know what might happen next. And at this point in the game, this is the move that white was aiming at. You can see that there's a harmony between these two stones that white has played in a way. And when white plays this extension on the lower side, next white is going to be looking at the covering here. And there's going to be, although black will probably capture that corner group, it's going to be okay if white can force black to put some stones in. And that is something I can go into detail later, but and for this commentary, I think I'm going to stop here. It's already a very solid lead for white. I'd say the game is fairly close before Comey. So white has the whole Comey to win by.
Right. Well, I think any of our viewers who have tried fighting with the AI is just because, what, you know, why not, right? What the heck? And it's, and look, let's be honest. Fighting with an AI is great. I mean, if you can fight and, you know, do it all well, it's going to do you quite well when you're playing human players. So nothing wrong with it. But it almost never works out very well, does it?
Well, you know, and I think in this version of AlphaGo, the strength of AlphaGo's positional judgment had already become so obvious, so apparent, that people were trying to find a different approach and starting to fight. So it's very reminiscent for me of the AlphaGo Lee Sedol match, where Lee Sedol was trying to fight sometimes.
That's right.
It doesn't quite work. And of course, AlphaGo was dealing with different time controls in this match, and people didn't know exactly how it would react. So they were trying various things against it.
Going to keep on discovering more new things. All right. As always, thank you, Michael. Thank you all for watching, and we'll see you next game.